Hello guys, me Karlo today, F5, and welcome to another edition of F1 23 Career Mode. So, I haven't commentated in a while, and my memory might get rusty if I go off tangents and make you guys sleepy. So, all I can say is, made it for Christmas, and hopefully, Happy New Year's to anyone. So, it's going to be 2024 as soon as we get for these next few days, and hopefully these new racing games will make me want to watch my YouTube channel more. So that would be my New Year's resolution. So anyways, I couldn't think of a fancy YouTube thumbnail title for this clip for F1, and so I'd say one at Qatar. What can you say? I mean, it's another one of these Middle Eastern racetracks, next to Bahrain, Abu Dhabi. That was Qatar, so at least I know my world geography, so I just don't have the best line that I'm running, but when I put it in medium AI difficulty, it makes it much simpler and easier to, like, have big leads over my competition. So I mean, this is what I'm looking for in a race car, and when I run, just run that line, that's all. And don't worry if you're a few seconds behind them and they actually bump into you and put you in the wall. I mean, spoiler alert, I put a few flashbacks. So I edited those parts out and actually put on the best highlights in my video clips. So yeah, so this is Q1, and as you see me race, let's see my time, 1:25, so 26, yeah, 1:26, so. Not a bad lap, but if you scroll through the video a lot further, I qualify near the front, so I mean, this is not a bad way to end 2023, just start on the pole. I'm not going to tell you if I won the pole or something, but I'm giving answers away, so. So I'll stop commenting here. Let you guys go on for your days. If you got any video games for Christmas, go just watch a few minutes here and there and then go to your games. I'm not forcing you guys to watch all videos of my clips versus your clips if you have a YouTube channel. So anyways, so I make it happen, kind of five. Hope you have a happy new year. Peace.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Ali, Leclerc and Lewis Hamilton. With qualifying wrapped up now, we have our grid lineup for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a fantastic race. Anthony Davidson also...
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Capacity will drop. Battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Well done.
Thank you.
lap of the race, final lap. Yes, thank you. Thank you for all your hard work out there. That was a really strong drive and a great finish. Well done.
So let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. Ali increases their championship lead. Well, that wraps up the sprint. All that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then. Welcome back to... Before we... And let's talk about Ali.
Charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. Overtake button more. It's time to utilize some of this energy. Come on. go now. Come on. That was a fantastic stop. Faster than we were expecting. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Take button, let's go. Ayumu's coming in for his stop. Fitted the hard tyres. Car ahead, now the hard compounds. Dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. Well done. Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the internal combustion engine. Be aware that we're going to start to see a loss of power. That's the 12th consecutive race win. What a result. This record is going to be difficult for anyone else to ever beat.
And that's the checkered flag. What an effort from the team here in Qatar. And a fully, fully deserved victory too. Well, Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today. But what set them apart from the rest?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. Let's have a look then at the driver standings. Ali increases their championship lead. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Ali.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
So we're coming to the end of my YouTube video right now, so give a thumbs up button if you like the video so much. Click on that bell button to subscribe for more content, and if you saw the recent video interesting, share the comment right below the description so you can share some thoughts and feelings with everybody in the community and make them feel welcome. So I make a happy Karlo 95. You all have a great day and peace out.